Hello everyone, here we talk about the Chebyshev theorem. Chebyshev theorem is also describing the data allocation, but this is for general situation. We do not have any assumption about the distribution of our data collection. For any data collection, at least 1 minus 1 over k squared, this much percentage of data values will fall within, or we say will be within, k standard deviation. Here we only require k is greater than 1. So the k standard deviation being described is interval with the center average value mu, and the left side mu minus k standard deviation, that is k sigma, and the right side, which is mu plus k sigma. So the interval described as mu plus minus k sigma, or we use the regular interval bracket. So the fact being described by Chebyshev theorem is the general situation regardless of how the data values are distributed. The statement is always true for any situation. At least in this statement is a key logic word. The theorem only indicated the bottom line of how much percent of the data belong to that center interval. Let's look at the example. The rental rates in the neighborhood are collected. We don't care about what kind of distribution, just a general situation. And we do know the average rental rate is $1,500 and standard deviation is $300. So based on Chebyshev theorem, see what kind of reasonable statements can we make about the rental rates in this neighborhood. So we can try it out. We can make a lot of reasonable statements. The only parameter here, k, must be bigger than 1. So let's try it out, k equals 2 or k equals 3. Just two examples. If k is 2, then from 1 minus 1 over k squared, we come out 75%. On the other side, with k equals 2, and we can calculate the interval. So center 1500, standard deviation 300, so we can come out $900 to $2100. So the statement would be, at least 75% of the data value are between $900 and $2100. Similarly, if we use 3 for k, then we turn out 1 minus 1 over k squared is 88.89%. And the mu plus minus k sigma would give us $600 to $2400. So we can make statement, at the least 88.89% of data values are between $600 and $2400. We can also try some other numbers. So not really has to be whole number. We can have any decimal number as long as k is bigger than 1. So let's try another 2. For example, 1.5 and 2.5. If k is 1.5, and then we turn out 1 minus 1 over k squared, we have 55.56%. Mu plus minus k sigma give us $1,050 and $1,950. So the statement is, at least 55.56% of data values are between $1,050 and $1,950. If k is 2.5, then 1 minus 1 over k squared give us 84%, and mu plus minus k sigma give us $750 and $2,250. So we can make statement like, at least 84% of data values are between $750 and $2,250. You may wonder how the real question going to be like, but here we have already give some example for you understanding what Chubb's theorem give us. So based on the same background, let's see. If the rental rate in the neighborhood is with average rental rate $1,500 and the standard deviation is $300. The question being asked, what center interval would have at least 75% of data values? Okay, we have at least 75% of data value. That's our information where we start. And we also have mean and the standard deviation. So from 75%, that's our information for us to figure out a k. That means 1 minus 1 over k squared would be 75%. With this kind of situation, what kind of k would be? So we solve this equation. Turn out k is 2. And then with this information about the k is 2, and we can calculate the center interval. Give us $900 and $2,100. That means we measure two standard deviations from the center. So the answer for this question is between $900 and $2,100. That is the center interval the question is looking for. When we twist this question around, the question could be asked in different way. We have the same background. Average rental rate $1,500 and standard deviation $300. Now the question asks, at least how much percent of data value are within $750 and $2,250? So the information we have is the interval, and this interval must be center interval around the center value $1,500, and we can see that. If it's not, that means we cannot solve this question. So $1,500 minus $750, which is the left side, we have the distance $750. If we use the right side minus the center value, also give us $750. That means we do have the center interval. Under this center interval, we try to figure out how much standard deviation from center to side. So that means we use 750 divided by 300. 300 is one standard deviation. After we do this division, we turn out we have 2.5 standard deviations. So that is the k we're looking for. And we use this k to figure out at least how much percentage. So that is 1 minus 1 k squared. 1 over k squared and give us 84%. So for the question, our answer is 84%. Question, at least how much percent? We answer, at least 84%. That's how we use Chubb's theorem. So we can have both directions. You develop this question based on the information being provided and you find out another side. See you next time.